Welcome to the IVM Podcast Network.
TFG Football is an IVM production, and you can also check out their other awesome shows like Geek Fruit with fellow and television geeks Tejas, Jishnu and Dinkar as they discuss the world of science fiction and nerd culture.
You're listening to TFG Football.
Hello and welcome everyone. This is the TFG Indian Football Podcast. Now joining me in the studio as always is Kevin and Chiranjeet are joining us via Skype. Now before we move on to what happened yesterday in the meeting, the big meeting that we all were waiting for. Well, now we were all, you know, on the weekend we were Friday night, I think everybody went mad. Everybody as in the Indian football fraternity, the family, the fans, everyone just went crazy and berserk on the news that India defeated Italy 2-0. No, clean. First of all, they scored 2 goals. Then yeah, then
the under 17 side.
Then it is the clean sheet, and then comes it's an under 17 team, which we saw struggling against big teams. So you know, everybody put up tweets. Even I put up one saying that hey, now we have two things. You know, we scored against Brazil, and then here we go. We even defeated Italy. But then comes the news that apparently it was not the Italy team. Let's just get Chiranjeet into this conversation. Chiranjeet, what was all that about? Did we actually play or not play?
No, obviously, we did not play the Italy under 17 team. And, you know, there were rumors going around that it's the B side that we will play. And in the end, it was Liga Pro and Liga Pro 2, which is the like third, fourth division in Italy. Hmm. It's the academies from those clubs, and they make up a representative side, and that's what played India under 17.
Hmm. Isn't this AIF supposed to know all of this? That's not.
Yeah, they are supposed to. Yeah. They are supposed to, and they're not supposed to. Like they're going to cite some technicality that okay, we asked for their under 17 team, and they gave us this under 17 team.
Hmm.
But you have to know the difference, right? I mean, people who the coaches, the team management who prepared for this match would have known that, okay, these are the guys that play in the Italian under 17 team.
Hmm.
And then you go and see an entirely different set of players turn up.
Yeah.
And you should immediately realize, okay, this is not Italy under 17 then.
Hmm.
But yeah, that's what happening. Apparently, there was a miscommunication. The Italy Football Association was pretty surprised that, like, okay, no, why are they saying they played Italy under 17 national team?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that the miscommunication created a lot of what do you call it, the confusion was created. Mm-hmm. And it gave the appearance that AIFF was trying to just pass off a smaller team as the Italy under 17 team.
Mm.
And this is not the first time that has happened as well. I mean, the Indian, I think, under 16 girls team also played a team from Germany and beat them. And there it was, you know, the media or the local AIF people who were there tried to pass it off as, okay, they beat the German team. So it's the difference between an Italian team and the Italian team. And, you know, AIFF should not have just gone around saying it was India playing Italy. And then all this could have been avoided.
Yeah. Yeah. I think it's like a high level of miscommunication, right?
Not miscommunication, you know, even if, something was decided that the Italian team is going to face the India under 17 team. And it does not happen. You have studied. You know what team is to be expected, what position, what players are there to be playing in what positions.
Yep.
You know, you always study your opponent. It's not a surprise that, oh, this player was not on the list of players that we were supposed to see.
Hmm.
So what side is this? At least go and find out if this was not your expected players. Is this the side that you were expecting? No. At least make it clear, even if it is late, it's not a problem. You can always have a correction. You send out one wrong information and everybody multiplies that. It's like a chain reaction. Everybody's talking, you know, everybody's so happy that India has beaten the under 17 side of the national side of Italy. And then in the acknowledgement is not there. Okay, we did goof up. They say that it's so lame to say that the Italian Federation was not told. They did not inform us. What is your study behind that? You were just dancing away. The tweet just says, okay, dance away the entire night. At least understand it is a victory. Okay, but at least get the side correct.
Hmm.
You know, it's irresponsible on the part of AIFF.
Yeah, I mean, just the highest level of miscommunication that they're saying, and how can you, being the body governing the football, do such a big blunder? I mean, we are not questioning the fact that India could not have beaten. We don't know that. There you go. You just splash it on us, and now you're, you know, making it's like a self-doubt. You're making us doubt our own things right now, because a win is a win at the end of the day. Whatever. We're not taking that away. But you could have clarified. You're the ones running, right? So there's so many mistakes. You can't do such blunders when you're playing friendlies and stuff just before your World Cup starts. It's also
what you do with your teams in India. It's okay. But about for the nation.
Yeah. It's like you shatter the boys' spirit in conference as well. You know, one day everybody was hailing them, and now they're like, oh, you don't even play the right team. But yeah, anyway, let's see how this turns out.
Overall, the Indian performance on the exposure trip has not been up to the mark.
This was one win apart from the two draws
and the remaining 5 losses. So this was something to cheer about everyone. And then all of a sudden, it just turned into disappointment.
I hope they don't, you know, get shattered by this and they continue playing their best performance. Now let's talk about finally what we want to talk about, the ISL bid updates. Now East Bengal and Mohun Bagan had this big meeting with the AIFF officials and IMG Reliance officials. Now, Chiranjit, before we talk about the meeting, what happened to Mr. Tutu Basu's press meet that he was supposed to spill a lot of beans?
A lot of songs,
yes. It has been postponed to.
Did he forget the lyrics
today
of the songs? That he had to postpone it?
Yeah, this is strategic.
Of course.
So what happened was that AIFF meeting happened, and I think announcing the press conference was also part of the pressure that we will just come out of the meeting and talk to the media or whatever. But something transpired, even though it does not look like they made much progress. And as we said, AIFF General Secretary has nothing to do with what ISL does. Okay, AIFF has no control over IMG Reliance. IMG Reliance runs AIFF, and that's the way it is. They cannot make a deal for East Bengal Mohun Bagan. They cannot even mediate. But what was a bit interesting was that Sundar Raman also took part in the meeting, and he's very close to the Reliance top brass. So maybe something transpired that gave them enough pause for thought that they decided, okay, let's not go to the media today, let's do it tomorrow, and weigh all our options and do all our meetings before that. So this does not mean that they got something positive out of this. It can easily be the negative, and they are just planning on going on war footing. And there are already some lower level officials saying, we will go out, we'll protest in the street, we'll burn effigies and all that shit. Useless talk. That's not how it works, and it's going to be productive in the end, at the end of the day. So what is happening is that just before the meeting was to take place, West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee just got into the game because obviously East Bengal, Mohun Bagan and Mohammedan Sporting, these three clubs, a lot of Trinamool Congress politicians are connected to the club, and it is part of the vote bank politics. You know, how you back these clubs will affect a lot of voters, especially in Kolkata and South Bengal. So she came out and literally threw him a warning shot at ISL that East Bengal and Mohun Bagan's demands of waiving franchise fee and playing from Kolkata are correct. They should be given that much leeway compared to other ISL franchises. And then she said, we will make sure that East Bengal and Mohun Bagan play all their matches from Kolkata's Salt Lake Stadium.
Wow.
And she said the stadium belongs to the state government, not ISL. So what she's implying is that she may even force Atletico de Kolkata to play out of the Rabindra Sarovar Stadium for the next season, while East Bengal and Mohun Bagan get the Salt Lake Stadium. Simply because there is a huge logistical problem that AIFF Vice President Subrata Datta was talking about. That if East Bengal and Mohun Bagan play in I League, and Atletico de Kolkata play in ISL, and they all use the Salt Lake Stadium, then you will have to take down the hoardings between every single game, maybe like twice a week. And you'll have to redecorate the stadium according to which tournament is being held over there. So that is a huge amount of headache that nobody wants to get. So yeah, maybe what she's saying that, okay, if you make them play in I-League, we will give the Salt Lake Stadium to East Bengal and Mohun Bagan, and you can play out of your Rabindra Sarovar. And you will never get as many people as you want. And anyway, Atletico de Kolkata, the fan base will take a beating this season, no matter what happens, because their feud against East Bengal Mohun Bagan has come out in public. And it was even aided by Saurav Ganguly's statement. And he came out. I mean, it was beyond any doubt. He said, hey, look, we need East Bengal and Mohun Bagan in ISL. They should come and play. But Atletico de Kolkata has exclusivity over over Kolkata, so they cannot play from Kolkata right now. So it's he's made a very ridiculous argument that he said, how can you expect Kolkata Knight Riders not to play from Eden Gardens? I mean, how does that make sense? East Bengal and Mohun Bagan have been playing in that stadium since it was created in the 1980s. It is their home ground. The stadium was created for East Bengal and Mohun Bagan. And how now Atletico de Kolkata is saying you cannot play from that stadium. And how does it? So he's actually like countering his own argument when Saurav Ganguly says, how can you expect Kolkata Knight Riders not to play and play from Salt Lake Stadium? And remember that nobody has said Atletico de Kolkata cannot play from Salt Lake Stadium. Okay. If what the Kolkata clubs are saying, let everybody play. Okay. They're not a separatist and anti-competitive side like Atletico de Kolkata is right now. So all of that is going into it. But with the West Bengal government's pressure, I think they're trying to build a political pressure on it. And whatever happened in the meeting, whatever discussion was held, it gave the East Bengal and Mohun Bagan club officials enough of a concern to say, okay, we will do an executive meeting of the clubs, which is happening today. And afterwards, they will go to Nabanno, which is the state government headquarters, where the sports minister of the state will meet with East Bengal, Mohun Bagan, and Mohammedan Sporting representatives. I don't know why Mohammedan Sporting is in the mix, but they just, you know, sab log aa rahe, tum log bhi aa jao, aisa is happening. Because Mohammedan Sporting don't play in the top division at the moment. So I don't really see them having any chance of making it to the ISL right now. But yeah, having them on board, it gets a lot of more public support behind the process as well. Because Mohammedan Sporting have one of the biggest fan bases in the country. You know, it gets depleted because they don't play in the major competitions anymore. The team has deteriorated. But yeah, they are the ones who got like some, you know, 50, 60,000 people in a Durand Cup final in Delhi. Win because they were playing. So yeah, those three clubs will meet the state sports minister, and maybe later tonight we will see a press conference where they will say everything. And remember, today is the 23rd of May. And if they are going to submit the bids, they will have to do it by tomorrow. So this is D-Day. They will have to make a decision today. We will know what's happening tomorrow. And even if they make a show of force tonight, by 25th morning, we will know exactly what's going to happen. Okay, so this is it. Time has run out. Enough talk, enough posturing, enough threats of, you know, public movement or whatever. Anybody can see through it. That does not produce any productive result. Now it's time for them to take what they can now, because otherwise they will miss out on it.
Now, Kevin, you heard what Sanjeev had to say, right? And we've also read the articles up on our website. What do you make of this?
I'm actually, you know, if I have to pull out any points out of this empty meeting, there's really none. You know, it's all everybody's trying to put in their own pressure from all sides, be it, you know, your political pressure or even your influence in football. You know, everybody is trying to show that I am in power, I am in power. And that's exactly why football is suffering. You know, had it been, you know, if it would have been just about football, we wouldn't even be landing in this mess. So I just hope everything just sorts out and it's good for the Indian football. Talking about the ISL, the I-League, Let's also take a look at the second division that just concluded.
Neroga
won the second division.
It was on the cards.
Yeah.
It was just on the cards. They had to take it while, just like how they were performing.
It's not, they have a match left. The league will still continue. They have one match day left, but Neroga has already secured a brilliant performance.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we also heard things, you know, when long back I was at the press conference, post-match press conference, I think when Mumbai was the last match of theirs, and everybody was talking about the second division. All of a sudden, we all the other fellow journalists were talking, you know, guess what, Neroka is doing really
well.
Because
Mumbai FC was going to the second division, wasn't it?
Yeah. And you know, all of that, and suddenly everybody was talking about Neroka was in suddenly the talk of the town, and why not? There you go. They already, with the match left.
What it means is second division winners do get a promotion and they play the top division of the country, which is a question mark right now. It's, you know, whatever it is. So again, we have another folding handed member along with Aizawl. It's Neroka who will be just watching the party. Okay, just give us a call after everything is sorted. We'll come in.
Yeah, and then we will be, you know, putting our bit over there. Now, Chiranjit, are you planning to visit the Neroka team as well?
Yeah, hopefully that will materialize over the next few days. But right now, it's all about, you know, tomorrow, it's going to be all about what happens on the ISL front and what's been cooking behind the closed doors, right? Yeah, because see, East Bengal and Mohun Bagan need to be there in order for AIFF to push for a legitimacy quest for ISL. You know, if East Bengal, Mohun Bagan, Bengaluru FC come on board, then suddenly ISL can become the top division. Whoever comes in extra, we've been hearing about Fateh Hyderabad. I don't know what they're thinking. This is not the time.
Yeah.
You know,
but,
I thought.
Before you say that point, I mean, just to say, don't forget what Praful Patel. I think Praful Patel has made those comments, right? No matter, irrespective of Bagan, Bengaluru, East Bengal coming to ISL, I League will still remain the top division league.
and since when does he like make that decision?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, to put down all those comments that he's been saying since day one, it's hilarious.
Yeah. And since he also said that I League will get the same kind of treatment that ISL will get, please give me a break, you know. We have not been blind all this time.
Well, in the coming days we will know. As just as Chiranjit mentioned, today is the 23rd, and you know, tomorrow the last day that they've been given, so if not tonight or tomorrow, we definitely will know what's happening and what will happen on 25th morning, and then see and then wait for the actual tamasha. What does the Aizawl have to do, the champions of the top division? What do they have to say after the short break that they've had?
I'm going to go out on a limb and make a prediction that this will not be the last invitation to bid.
Okay.
Even if East Bengal and Mohun Bagan make a bid and they get into ISL, we may just see next month or the month after next month a second invitation to bid being floated. And that could become the road for Aizawl FC to just somehow sneak in if they can find a corporate backup. Let's see how that goes.
Yeah, well, let's see. We'll have to all you have to do is see and hope what happens. You know, nobody can predict the future. Not even the ones who are running it. Yeah, exactly. Fingers crossed is how we are sitting right now. Now, that's all for today's show. If you enjoy the show, then hit the like, share, subscribe to our channel, hit the bell icon so you get updates of our new episode. You can also listen to our show on iTunes, Audio Boom, SoundCloud and various other podcasting apps. Follow the TFG Football Twitter handle to keep yourself updated about everything about Indian football. You can also read about all these stories. It's up on our website, thefangarage.com. Talk to us directly. You can do that. Chiranjit Toja, Boza_Kevin, SujuMatthew94. Have a great day, folks. Cheers.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is your captain speaking. Sorry to say, but there's been a slight delay due to the apocalypse having suddenly begun. As you can see, there's death, destruction, and chaos taking place all around us. But don't you worry, food and drinks will be served shortly, and I would recommend checking out
IVM Podcasts
to get some of your favorite Indian podcasts. We'll keep you going till this whole thing blows over. Thank you.